Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. It's Friday, 17th of September. This is part of my daily update. As I say, out of the field, it's not possible to give a visual, but an audio one, inshallah. So today, this morning, we went back to the village which we went to yesterday in Muslimabad, where we found a 9-year-old who had this hole in his heart and needed an emergency surgical procedure of some sort. The family hadn't been able to afford the surgery, and so he
shocking that these people are all displaced as a result of the flood. They had no homes.
and actually forced to move people along. So that's been shocking. Again, the conditions there were terrible. People just living, you know, literally on top of each other. They had a small medical clinic again set up within that camp itself. And again, it was absolutely overwhelmed. And again, we were able to supply some medication to them. We take their details and we'll supply much more medication now that we, you know, ascertain exactly what they need and what's going on. Again, tonight, there were 20 women out of the 4,000 people that are there. There were 20 to 30 women who were over 9 months pregnant. And that means they are literally due to give birth, you know, every day now, really. And again, the camp organizers are telling us that they've got no real means of giving birth in a safe way. And they're just absolutely, they're just begging us to supply some equipment. So again, that was absolutely terrible, but it's pretty shocking in terms of just the sort of conditions these people have to live without. The charities, it's common. They said to me that this is being replicated across 100 schools in that particular province. So if you just do the math, it's just a phenomenal number of people who are involved in that process. And that doesn't include more than 10 villages that have been set up, etc., so on and so forth. Again, we've recorded some of that in charity. When we get an opportunity, we'll upload that. We've had a brief video interview with the camp director as well, just to get his thoughts and his words in terms of what he needs the most. That took us into the evening when we then delivered some medication to some medical relief camps and just made sure everything was in check in terms of the bureaucracy of things. Tomorrow, inshallah, we'll be back in the capital. Islamabad is the plan. And what we're now doing is now having established the various camps, exactly what they need, exactly what their requirements are, and having seen for ourselves firsthand exactly what's going on, we've delivered approximately just over £2,000 worth of medication. We have partners for something approaching £20,000 worth of medication. So now we're going to have the camps where they are and the rest of it start setting up, you know, larger supplies to these relevant camps for the medication to be delivered to the people. So that's the plan over this weekend, Saturday, Sunday, using whatever resources we have. I mean, on Monday I'm due to fly back to the UK, but obviously this work will continue long after I left the development documentation, the development procedures. Now we've made all the right contacts and we've worked with all the relevant NGOs on the ground.